Evan Gray, 105 Through the Fan. Luca, you obviously had massive playoff performances before. Do you even get surprised at yourself sometimes at the kinds of performances that you have in these kinds of moments the way that you did tonight in a game that you guys obviously had to have in this series?
I mean, I could have played way better, you know. I missed a lot of shots, some layups that I should have made. But it wasn't just me, man. It was the whole team, the energy. Dora was unbelievable. DP, I mean, Dwight Powell with his energy. KP with a big shot. Timmy with a big shot, you know. And the whole team was just there bringing up the energy.
Rachel Nichols.
Hey, Luca. Just wondering, from your past playoff experience in Europe, what was the series or sort of games that you remember playing there that taught you the most that you can apply and that translate to playoffs in the NBA?
I mean, I remember being physical. You know, they were physical. But it's big games, you know. You got to play hard. You got to play with heart. I don't know what else to say. But, you know, just it was physical. You got to be ready for everything.
Do you remember how young you were when you played your first really big, this is really important, big deal playoff game?
Probably like 17, 18, 17. We lost in semifinal. So.
Thank you, Luca.
Okay, Mark Medina.
Mark Medina, USA Today. What's the past few days been like with managing the injuries, and how was it feeling throughout the game?
I mean, it wasn't nothing that was that much, you know, just like I said, some massages, eyes down, you know. And the most important thing was rest and, like I said, massage, you know. And then today was, I was feeling way better.
Brad Townsend.
Yeah, Luke, Brad Townsend, Dallas Morning News. It looked like when you were sitting out this first couple of minutes, literally 2 minutes of the fourth quarter, you were getting pretty fidgety over there. What was going through your mind, and was there conversation between you and Rick about when you were going in? Because you hopped off the bench pretty quickly there.
I mean, no, I just saw him calling me. So, I mean, I was ready anytime. But like I said, you know, in the fourth, I didn't play great. I didn't play good. Some shots was in and out, but we won the game, and that's all that matters right now.
Tim McMahon.
Tim McMahon, ESPN. Luca, what did you think of the big lineup with Boban? And obviously, you guys are playing zone defensively. How does that change things for you offensively?
I mean, that was a pretty big challenge for all of us. You know, we got to change our game plan. But as you see, I mean, it turned out great, you know, and we'll see what we do next time, but I think everybody was great today.
Tim Cato.
Tim Cato, The Athletic. Luca, I think you said your instinct is kind of that you're always looking to pass first, so I'm curious if you ever remember a game you've taken 37 shots in, and whether you're prepared to, you know, keep shooting that many times if the need so arises the rest of the series.
I think it was too much. I shot some shots that I shouldn't shot. I honestly think it was too much, but, you know, like I said, I missed a couple layups, you know, a couple shots. I think I was good from the three, but I missed a couple layups. But, you know, we got to win. Like I said, you know, that's all that matters in the end of the day. And, you know, that's it.
Okay, we're going to move to Spanish. Pedro.
Pedro Silva, Univision Dallas. Luca, ¿cómo describes tu desempeño esta noche, no solamente ofensivamente, pero en la defensiva? Porque las manos estuvieron muy activas para forzar pérdidas, especialmente en el tramo final del partido, y lo que va a ser el sexto partido en casa, que para ustedes quizás sea clave de poder liquidarlo ya en Dallas.
Sí, la verdad que creo que todo el mundo estuvo bien en defensa, sobre todo Dorian, pero creo que hemos hecho un trabajo increíble, como usted ha dicho, con las manos. Y bueno, hay que salir muy duros el sexto partido e intentar ganarlo.
Eric.
Luca, me gustaría preguntarte acerca de ese sexto partido aquí en casa. En los primeros dos que se jugaron aquí había muchas expectativas y desafortunadamente no se pudieron ganar, pero el ambiente fue fenomenal. Va a haber un ambiente muy similar. La gente se va a ir a apoyarlos, pero ¿qué tienen que hacer ustedes diferente? ¿Qué tiene que hacer el equipo diferente para ya acabar con esta serie aquí en casa?
Bueno, ojalá acabemos en casa, ¿no? Tenemos que ganar 1-2. La gente estuvo increíble y la verdad que esperamos ganar el sexto partido ahí. Ojalá lo ganemos y hay que salir muy duros.
Claudia Gestro, Los Ángeles Post Examiner. Ya tienes experiencia con el equipo. ¿Qué has aprendido de estos últimos años que te pueden ayudar a triunfar en esta postemporada?
Bueno, cada día se aprende algo, ¿no? En cada partido tienes que ir viendo las cosas, leer la defensa, y creo que cada día se aprende algo.
Okay, last question, Leonardo.
Hola, Luca, te saluda Leonardo Torres desde Perú. Felicidades por la victoria. Luca, ¿cuál fue el principal ajuste que hiciste del partido anterior a este? ¿Y cuán importante será la hinchada, la presencia del público a favor en el sexto juego?
Bueno, no ha sido bastante diferencia. Hemos jugado más duro. Y bueno, vamos a intentar, como he dicho, acabar en el sexto partido en casa con nuestro público.